Musa, and he looks, he's a nice young man. Inna khayra man ista'jarta al-qawiyyul amin. The best one, that you can hire, a worker that can help you, is someone who is strong and who is trustworthy. Trustworthy, amin. Values the trust. Because you as a young man is a trust to your wife, and your wife is a trust to you. Both of you are trusts to each other, and both of you are entrusted to each other by Allah Rabbul Alameen. Equally so. Ya abati istajir. Look at this. At this beauty of talk. Oh Father, hire, if you want to hire somebody, you probably should take a look at hiring this young man, because the best qualities that you should look for are the one who is strong and trustworthy. Trustworthy. You trust him. Not a word that we say, but you actually trust. Big word, trust. Big word. What did she tell him? Inna abi yad'uk. My father calls you to our home. Not I'm going to marry him regardless whether my parents agree or not, because that's my decision in life. Under all these rules of calculation, like I said, because it's a calculation now. What is, what's the way to do it? This is, you know, my I'm going to do this with it. Yeah. I'm going to fight the whole world because I love you so much. Yeah. But at one, after, you know, the phase of admiration of when the life comes in and all these things, and I'm not saying that we're going to talk about admiration and love afterwards, but that can, when you live every single day's life, that heat of passion goes away a little bit. And you deal with things as they're supposed to be. The reason I'm saying this is, dear brothers and sisters, is to avoid subjugating and limiting the word love to a specific understanding, while it should be very general. What I'm trying to tell you is, many people think that getting married is an objective and a goal. Hadaf, objective. Objective in life, I'm going to get married. So therefore, that objective is what? What's that goal for? Satisfying a desire, whatever it is. Fulfilling an inferiority complex, whatever it is. That's if you consider getting married or finding a partner is an objective or a goal. But you have to change that and remember that getting married is not a goal. Getting married, let me just reprioritize that whole thing. Getting married is means to a goal, not a goal in itself. Getting married is means to a goal. What is the goal? Pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the goal. If you make marriage as a goal itself, you've got different kinds of calculations. But if you make marriage, if you understand that marriage is only means, when you are actually trying to get married, you are actually trying to perform a worship with a correct niyyah, correct intention of worship, and executing worship tools and worship facilities, because you're trying to please Allah with this. Your objective is to please the Creator in this marriage. And that's why you're getting married in the beginning, you're not getting married because marriage itself is a goal. You're getting married because marriage is means to a goal, which is رضا الله ورضوان من الله أكبر. If we do this, then if we correct our compass to what the objective is, we can have a good start. Usually, things that have good start have good end, usually. So what's the rule then? What do we do? Alright, so married, we have now intention, we want to seek a life partner, we want to fall in love with somebody for the pleasure of Allah, we want to get married. Khair, very good. What are the things that we need to look for? Al-hadith wadih, and it's known, two things. إِذَا أَتَاكُمْ مَتَضَوْنَ دِينَهُ وَخُلُقَهُ فَزَوِّجُوهُ. Deen and khuluq. Deen and khuluq. Khuluq is morality, deen is deen, faith, you know that. Imam al-Suyuti and others narrate this. Let me tell you this story. It's not a story actually, it's a hadith. And that hadith with authentic isnad, it's not sahih. An Thawban radhiyallahu anhu. Sahabi. He says, when the ayah came, وَالَّذِينَ يَكْنُزُونَ الذَّهَبَ وَالْفِضَّةِ ثُمَّ لَا يَنْفِقُونَهَا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ, those who treasure, the meaning of the ayah, those who treasure gold and silver, and they don't give it away in the path of Allah, tell them that they're awaiting severe punishment, عذاب أليم. Those who treasure means what? Usually what do you do with treasure? You keep. يكنزون, يتخذون, they save the gold and silver. But Al-Quran Kareem says يكنزون, and kenz comes from treasure. And usually treasure is well kept, hidden. When this ayah comes, as-sahaba radiallahu anhu, those who treasure gold and silver and they don't spend it in the path of Allah, let's spend everything we have in the path of Allah. As-sahaba radiallahu anhu says, Ya Rasulullah, أيُّ الْمَنِ نَتَّخِذ, hadith says, what kind of money should we then treasure? Or what kind of thing should we treasure? If we don't treasure it, we don't keep gold and silver. You want to hear the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's answer? What should you treasure? Three things. But before that, sallu ala rasulullahi wa alayhi. Also another time, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala Sayyidina Muhammad. And the third time. They say the third time is a charm. I didn't hear it. Ya Rasulullah, what kind of treasure should we have? What kind of treasure? So we cannot treasure gold and silver? أَيُّ الْمَنِ يَتَّخِذْ قَالَ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَمْ قَلْبًا, number one, لِسَانًا ذَاكِرًا وَقَلْبًا شَاكِرًا, a heart that's thankful to Allah, and a tongue that is ذَاكِر, always mentioning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Things that you are to treasure. And what else? وَزَوْجَ صَالِحَ وَزَوْجَ مُؤْمِنَ تُعِينُهُ عَلَى أَمْرِ الْآخِرَةِ. Number one is إذن قَلْبًا ذَاكِرًا, قَلْبًا شَاكِرًا, وَلِسَانًا ذَاكِرًا, وَزَوْجَةً مُؤْمِنَ تُعِينُهُ عَلَى الْآخِرَةِ. Three things that you should treasure. A tongue that's thankful always. When a tongue that's mentioning Allah all the time. This is a treasure. Treasure. What else you treasure? You treasure also a heart that's thankful. A lot of people, they have things, but they don't treasure them. Allah gives you bounties every day. People don't thank Allah for them. He gives you the vision every single day. Renews His ni'mah on you every single day when you wake up. You open your eyes and you see. A word of thanks. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah for the healing He gives you every single day. For the power that He gave you to come to this session today. For the power that He gave you to enjoy hearing other people that you like. For the power He gave you to mention Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, that requires thanking. Thanking Him requires thanking for allowing us to thank Him jalla jalalu. For you wouldn't have been able to thank Him had it not been for Him allowing you to thank Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. لِسَانًا ذَاكِرًا وَقَلْبًا شَاكِرًا. But what else? A pious, Allah, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, a pious spouse. Helping to pass to the Akhirah. A pious spouse? How does the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam describe the pious spouse? Treasure. Treasure. If you have a pious spouse, it's a treasure. You ought to treasure her. She ought to treasure you. This is a treasure, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Therefore, by Allah. The one who is happy, don't listen to people telling you all kinds of things. The one who is happy is the one who is happy at home. Even if the whole world is against him. And the one who is unhappy is the one who is unhappy at home. Even the whole world is with him. When you go to your home, whether you are a husband or wife, that's supposed to be your comfort zone. If you are happy there, wallahi, if the whole dunya